From Universal Studios Hollywood, welcome to Home and Family.
Brighten up your day, the Home and Family way.
Welcome to Home and
Family.
There it is.
Welcome, everybody.
There it is. We wouldn't be Home and Family. We would be a team if I said it both.
We usually do, but we are. Everybody collectively, that's who we are. So welcome. Welcome.
We're glad that you could be here with us today. Let's jump right into this, shall we? Because we have a full show.
Yeah, big show today.
And some wonderful guests. You know our first guest, Will Estes, is here. You know him as Jamie Reagan from CBS's Blue Bloods. This is a good show, my friend. And you have some wonderful mentors that you look up to in this. Yeah,
absolutely. Tom Selleck plays the father on the family and the commissioner.
Yeah.
Do you want to know a secret?
What's the secret?
Tom Selleck was my first date when I was 16 years old.
Really?
Yes. And what's really crazy is that our kids that are grown up, his daughter Hannah and my daughter now Ariana, are besties.
Wow.
How crazy is that?
Wow.
That's
wild.
I know. Yeah, but it's my first
date. Another secret?
What?
He was my second date.
There it is.
No, he had a joke in there somewhere, and I didn't know where to go.
Oh, okay.
And then it went downhill, and it didn't go well.
Well, if you see him, tell him Cindy said hello.
Okay.
She'll know exactly.
Cindy.
Cindy. My first name is Cynthia. Christina. Okay. And so you call me Cynthia.
Maybe. Okay.
Maybe, yeah.
So maybe when I get mad or angry
Don't
with you, I will call
He's
you
He's the only
Cynthia.
Person allowed to call me Cindy. Anyway, welcome. It's so nice to have you here.
Thank you so much.
So much to talk about.
Yes.
Yeah.
Also with us today, talking with us, actor Jocko Sibbs. He is here talking with us about a couple of things. Very busy man. This summer's blockbuster, Dawn of the Planet of the Apes. We have some behind-the-scenes footage of how this all comes together and how these actors really take on. It's not makeup anymore. Where do you see the technology that's there? And The Last Ship, which he's been involved with as well. Mm-hmm. Welcome. It's good to have you on.
Absolutely.
Good to have you on board.
Yeah.
And I mean that in the punniest of ways.
Absolutely.
Funniest?
Very good to be here.
Hey, where's Jocko come from? What is that?
Jocko is actually a name that was given to me by my grandmother.
Really?
Yeah, my real name is Jackie. I am the third, as my grandfather and my father are named after them, but for some reason, legend has it, the day I was born, my grandmother said, let's call him Jocko. So much like you, I have two names.
Two names, there you go.
Yeah.
All right, that's
good.
Well,
we're going with Jocko. Perfect. All right.
Okay.
You want to go on from there?
Should we talk about our...
Oh, you really?
No, okay.
So look,
so listen to this.
Here's the... Okay. Okay, I don't know, because I know this is going to make us sound bad and look bad, but I'm going to say this anyway. So we're up for an Emmy, and you know, with Emmy, all that. Thank you. So you get to go out to these events. Now I say you get to go out with some hesitation because Christina and I.
We never.
It's
go out.
Hard to crowbar me, I know, out of the house
Impossible.
Past like 8 o'clock.
Yeah, forget it.
In fact, I looked around. I go, is this what people call going out?
Yeah.
When we went to this Emmy reception, we had a great time.
Yes, we did.
In fact, we got all spiffied up.
Look at us.
There we are.
Our Emmy.
We went out. That's not our Emmy.
I'm kidding.
That is not our. But so we had to go get a picture, and then you know we work with a very vibrant
producers,
team family producers that are just full of zest.
Look at our family.
And I look at really look at I'm blessed. I'm so blessed to get to stand in the midst of all the wonderful beauty and talent. And so, Christine and I are working the party, and we decided it's time to go. They come in the morning and go, we're like, how late did you stay out? They were at like 11, 12 o'clock at night.
12:30 and then some.
And that's what they look like. Here is a picture of Christina and I at 9 o'clock at night. Back home, she fell asleep. Christina spent the night over at my place because her drive in the morning is much shorter from where I live.
Yeah,
so.
But let's just mention, along with my girls, they came with me too.
Alex
and Ariana were there, and you very graciously let us stay
We bought some food. And I said, I go, let's look at the show for tomorrow and see what our crack producing team put together. And I started reading the show to her, and next thing I know, I hear snoring sounds.
I'm not snoring.
She was out cold.
I'm not snoring.
I thought it was Fred the dog snoring, and it was Christina.
No, he's reading me the segments, and of course we ordered, you know, what did we take out? Of course, we had
takeout.
Fell right to sleep, I know. But thank you for letting me stay.
Yeah.
It was very nice of you.
It was
but
good.
That's how devoted we are to this show. I mean, we work really hard at night, but we lasted till 9. And we heard all the stories after about you guys afterwards. We heard them.
And there was a little, right where Christina was, there was a little tiny thing of drool.
Yeah,
just there.
Okay, we're moving. Okay, that's it. All right. Kim, how do you like the way he treats me?
Hi, Kim Douglas.
I'm so glad you're getting some of it now.
Yeah.
Ryan. Hi. What do you have today, Kim?
You know what? I am going to show you some of the most fun, innovative, like 2014 cutting edge baby products for our little mother with child right over here. And everything is so fun and a little bit off the beaten path because that's just who I am. But how about this little teether, and it's got a gold grill.
Oh my gosh.
Man, I like that.
Whoa, let me see.
I like that, yeah.
Wow, I think I'm gonna name my baby Snoop Dogg. Or Lil Jon. Lil Jon, Lil Wayne.
Oh, yeah. We've all got our little, our little
thing. Oh my gosh.
Aren't they fun? So I've got these and more to show you in just a little while.
That's what they do when they're done with them, by the way. Right.
This is great. It has gold on it. I like
really
it. It's shiny.
You do as soon as we
I'm gonna keep
don't keep that,
that
one. I spit it on the
That is so cute.
I like it.
You get one, Seth gets one, all the baby mommy
so cute. Isn't that great?
I had a new work.
You have a really? Yeah.
You get one too.
I'll show you a picture.
Okay.
I just want to remind Jocko that he is actually not on the last ship. Yeah. Maybe on the last show he ever does in his career, but it's not the last ship. I just wonder what you guys are thinking sitting here.
Where
they got quiet
I?
All of a sudden. I feel them sort of going back like this, going, what's going on?
Yeah, I know.
I'm about to get one.
Don't pick up that one.
I don't have any kids yet, but
I know.
There it is.
There you go. Debbie, what you got?
Debbie, we're done.
Yeah, what do you have?
Everyone's taking it. I have a makeover.
Makeover.
The best makeover you're ever going to see. It's Makeover Monday, and she's not wearing a grill, I promise you. All right, so I got to get to my makeover, by the way.
Oh, yeah, now, go. We'll check in
Debbie,
with you in just a
minute. Debbie, promise me don't run in those shoes, please.
I promise
don't
not to run.
All right.
Oh,
look at her.
Nobody can stop that woman. Nobody. All right, also with us today, Jamie Durie is here. Welcome, Jamie. He's an award-winning horticulturist. Hosted more than 50 TV shows, including the Outdoor Room and the Victory Garden, and he's here with us talking about his newest book, Jamie Durie's Edible Garden.
Welcome.
G'day, guys. How are you?
Good day to you. So,
yeah.
Wow.
I'm very, very happy to be here. I've got to say, very excited, because I hear you guys are both gardeners, right?
Yes.
She more than I.
Very much so. And I showed you our garden over our home and family garden, which I'm so proud of.
I know. I'm so impressed. This is a real house. It's a
Yeah.
Who sleeps here at night?
We do.
Oh, okay. Perfect.
We never leave.
I know, we never leave. I love this idea that you're sharing with us about a vertical garden.
Yeah, this is all about the vertical garden. So it's essentially learning how to plant not just flowers, but beautiful edible plants into a vertical landscape. So it's sort of like covering up all those ugly old fences and putting lush landscapes up onto a vertical plane where you can sort of see it for all of its beauty, but also enjoy the fruits of your labor, because you've got basil and oregano and basil and oregano and all that stuff. You know what I mean? You know what I'm talking about, right?
Wouldn't it be lovely if we could do that on the outside of our fence where our tram goes by, which one is coming by now, but on the other side, wouldn't it be lovely if they could see beautiful landscapes on the gate? Let's do it.
They could pick, like, fresh herbs
as they
go by. They could
pick herbs as they leave.
Yeah. Right?
Go ahead, pick some basil or oregano.
Hi, everybody. But I got to say, this system, it really is very, very simple. It's just like, vertical gardening for dummies. You essentially just plant it all out. It's got irrigation system in it. It's ready to
go. Great. You're going
to
show us how to do that later.
I'm going to show you how to do it.
All right. And in the meantime, the executive chef and owner of Greenspan's Grilled Cheese and the winner of the 2008 Grilled Cheese Invitational, Chef Eric Greenspan is with us today. Now, Eric is here. You're going to be making an award-winning cheese sandwich, a grilled cheese
sandwich. Absolutely. It's what I do.
It's what you do.
What do you need to put in? Because it's grilled cheese.
Yeah. Oh, you'll see. It gets a little bit fancier than that. Obviously, yes, it's bread, butter, and cheese is your basics, but you wouldn't have me here on the fancy boob tube.
It
goes more to it than that.
Wow.
Yeah, you'll like it. It's a darn good sandwich.
Yeah.
Well, it's award-winning.
That's why I live here.
See, did I tell you what you're going to eat? You get
clear. I happen to be here, too.
Jocko, did I not tell you you're going to eat well when you're here?
Absolutely.
Okay, great.
And I know somebody who's going to enjoy that sitting on her mommy's lap. Tanya is here with her daughter, Ava.
Yay! Look who I have here today, everybody. Ava's finally here. And this is because she and I made the coolest DIY that has to do with a lot of water and pool noodles, but it has nothing to do with a pool. Oh. I can't give it all away.
Okay.
But you and I are going to be soaking wet by the time we're done, right?
Yes, they're a magician.
Oh, yeah. High fiver. High five.
Also with us today, our guest has gone from improv comedy to CIA operative. Agent, not joking,
wow.
True story.
Yeah.
And now she's a travel security expert and she's going to spread some knowledge on us. Emily Brandwin is here with us.
Good to have you.
Quite a transition. But some
normal
good
normal transition.
Yeah,
right?
Just a normal
totally
walk.
Totally normal.
Yeah, perfect. But with some good information for those
great,
traveling.
Great tips, easy tips that anyone can do when they're traveling overseas. It'll help you feel safe and secure when you're traveling.
Fantastic. And you don't have to take a noodle with
no.
you.
No.
No, no.
That's
no
optional.
Yeah.
I love the things that you brought today. Very innovative.
Good stuff.
I'm so going to use them. So.
All right. Do you think Debbie made it over there?
I'm sure she's there by now. She was running so fast. I'm sure she's there by now.
All right, Debbie.
Big step for her, straightening out those curls.
Big step for us when we come back. Will Anstis is here. We're going to chat. Don't go away.
I love 2571. I love that.
We're back. Will Estes is here. He plays Officer Jamie Reagan on CBS's hit show Blue Bloods. I've always wanted to play either a cop or a fireman.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, you know, like to
that's
be.
So cute.
Instead, I grew up to be a TV host. I don't.
That's
I kind of. I know, but I don't feel like I'm
good.
Saving anybody or really doing.
You are.
No, but
day.
You always. You wanted to as well.
I always wanted to play a cop on television, and I always wanted to live in New York, and so this job was sort of the best of both.
What kind of cop though? Like detective, secret, like undercover agent, or like
the guy. Just wanted to run around and get bad guys, and you know, in out of the uniform didn't matter. I just wanted to, you know, drive cars. And
but you're a detective.
I never grew up, basically, is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
That's good. Well, I don't know a man who ever has, to be honest with you.
That's
okay.
True. We take pride in that. We
just like you said, you want to be a cop or a fireman. You know, how old are you? You know, and you keep saying it.
Well, you do, because you one day you grow up, and that's
they're like
what,
cool jobs.
Yeah. But you love this cool job because you get to work with incredible people, and you have Tom Selleck.
Yeah. Donnie Wahlberg is like the engine of the show. Yeah. You know, you can't stop him. He'll work like a 14-hour day, and then go home and work on his music, and now he's got another show, I think, the Wahlburgers, where he started a restaurant with his brother, and he just never stops.
Well, let's see you not stopping. We've got a clip of the show. Take a look. Here we go.
We got two suspects throwing shots from behind that car.
Okay. Go, go, go. Police, drop your weapons! All right, stay here, I'm going around.
Stay. Give it up! You're not getting out of here!
Drop him! Put him on the ground right now! On the ground! Put him down!
On the ground now!
On the ground, hands behind your head!
On the ground!
Central 12, David, keep him coming. I got two under, one fled the scene.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Wait, what happened?
Did they shoot her?
You gotta tune in Friday night.
No,
what happens in that episode, actually, is that the police officer that runs off shoots that boy. And he had a gun, and then there's a discrepancy as to whether or not he had a gun.
Oh.
So it's a big, it's a big deal for the police.
Do you have to train for stuff like that?
Not at all. No, I'm kidding.
No.
We have a wonderful tech on the show. We go to him for everything. Jim Nusaforo, he was on the NYPD for 24 years, detective first grade. And so we go to him for everything. We try to get it as, you know, as correct as possible.
Did you through weapons training and all that as well? How to hold a gun, how to fire a gun?
Yeah, we touch on all of that. Yeah, a little bit of everything. But yeah, he gave us a packet at the very beginning, like that. And I probably read at least 10% of it. And then I go straight to him, and I do it for the hands-on training, and he gives me everything else. But I go to him for everything.
What?
I read something interesting about you, that when you had the uniform on, and there were two detectives that came up to you, and one started talking to you like you were a real cop.
Well, I was immediately sort of flattered, because these two guys came up, and they're wearing suits, and you realize, I realized they were detectives. You kind of, once I've been around these guys long enough, you can tell a guy who wears a suit a certain way is a detective. And they said, let me ask you a question, and he was going to ask him about the set. And the other guy said, he's not a real cop. And he goes, what are you talking about? And he goes, the collar brass. Because up here we have a 12, which means 12th precinct. Well, there is no 12th precinct.
So
he knows. So I immediately knew who the better detective was.
What's the hardest part? You know, you think, oh, you see an officer pull up in a situation like that. There's weapons involved. They jump out. They immediately have to take their, you know, weapon out of their holster.
Yeah.
I imagine there's playing a cop, but then having to carry that energy of knowing I've got to do my job. But boy, as soon as that comes out, it's a real thing.
Yeah, it's a. I think it's a really difficult job for just the reason that you said. It's like, you know, you've got to protect people, you know, and you've got to get the bad guy, and you never really know what a situation is walking in.
Right.
So it's, you know, that's why it's a difficult and a dangerous job.
Yeah. Well, have you guys gotten close as a cast?
Yeah.
You guys hang out much or do things outside?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
They probably don't go to Emmy parties like we do and stay up past 9 o'clock.
I bet you do.
You're also in an independent film called Automotive.
Yeah, I'm very excited.
What is it about?
Yeah,
this is creepy.
It's in a good way.
It is in creepy. A good way.
It's sort of a neo noirish piece. It's being called. It's really about a crime gone wrong. And sort of everything sort of a
wait, are you on the other side of the law this time and the crime?
I'm back and forth, yeah.
Okay.
Mostly the other side. It's a character that sort of means well and isn't a bad guy, but does. He gets caught up on the wrong side of a robbery.
But it's also shot differently as well.
It is, yeah. It's actually something you don't notice at first. I think it would initially sounds restrictive, but the concept for the film, the entire thing is shot with the camera inside of a 1964 Mercury Montclair. So sometimes you see more of the car and sometimes you see very little of it, but it's sort of almost the perspective of the car.
Yeah.
And it's, I'm not sure why Tom Glenn, our writer's director, I'm not sure why he wanted to do that as a concept, but I think it's sort
different.
Of serves the story really
yeah.
well.
Well, let's look at that.
Yeah,
that sounds interesting. Yeah. Take a peek. I was asking you how many cars.
One car, and we were short a mechanical department, so we actually had zero mechanical department. So I actually did a few repairs while we shot that car. Yeah,
that's why it's called independent film.
One time we put gas in it, and gas started coming out the bottom, and I said, "Do you have duct tape?" And he said, "Yes, I do." I said, "I'll be right back." And I fixed it.
And you fixed it.
He got us home. We replaced a few.
Well, you are handy, which takes us into what you do at home. I mean, very eco-conscious.
I guess I am.
Where does that come from?
The term or me?
Well, let's go with you.
Yeah. You know, when I was growing up younger, and I grew up in Southern California, and I loved the ocean since I was a little kid, and I would go surfing, and then it would rain, and in Los Angeles they tell you not to get in the water when it rains, and because the city essentially washes off into the ocean. And from the time I was a little kid, I sort of thought that was a travesty. I thought the ocean was sort of this free, beautiful thing for everyone. And I thought it was a shame that, you know, we can't keep it cleaner than that. So that was sort of the birth of the
But you went from that to now your own home and what you mm-hmm. do. Take us through a little bit of what you've done to your home.
Okay, sure. Yeah, well, I'm in the middle right now of trying to do, like, all native, like, landscape and low water.
Uh-huh. What does that mean, native landscape? Just the thing that's indicative to the...
Yeah, I'm not strict about being native. I have a couple things that are already there that are sort of established. Uh-huh. But I don't want to put anything else in that's real water intensive here in Southern California.
Sure. Right.
And a little while back, I was able to sort of follow in the footsteps of Ed Begley Jr., your guys.
We love him. Yeah, he's here a lot.
I worked with him. I don't know if he remembers me or not. I yelled at him. I saw him once in traffic. I said, Ed, and he was like, hi.
I'm sure he remembers everybody who's conscious about saving the earth. That's his passion as well.
Sure, yeah.
Did you put panels in or anything like that?
Yeah, I was able to add solar panels, to my house. A little over 4 years ago.
Is that hard?
Is that you?
It was hard,
installing it?
Yeah.
That's you.
I did that?
I took a class at college because I'm really into it. And and I was learning about it. And about halfway through, I met Josh. That's Josh. And I said, and he came in. He was a guest speaker. And I said, if you do the panels at my house, I said, can I do the install with you guys? And he said, yeah, sure. And so I said, all right, let's do it.
It's great.
It's good. You roll up your sleeves and you do that.
Yeah, it was fun.
Fantastic. All right. Well,
maybe you can come back and put it on our house here at Home and Family with Mark.
I'm not qualified.
Oh.
But I can do all the labor.
Well, bring that guy under the roof there. Bring him with you.
Yeah, he can do it.
Yeah, okay.
He can do it.
Those things are really warm. You could probably grill some grilled cheese sandwiches on
them.
Oh. You think so?
Yes.
Yeah. No, you can't. By the way,
you
can get more from Will at Home and Family TV on our Twitter page. Check that out.
Will is going to come into the kitchen with Chef Eric Greenspan to make these incredible grilled cheese sandwiches.
Awesome.
You're going to be happy you did.
Yeah.
We'll be right back.
I'm Chef Eric Greenspan, and I'm not just making grilled cheese sandwiches. I'm making grilled cheese sandwiches like this.
Oh, that is a mountain high grilled cheese right there. That's the way it's supposed to be. Christina is a sous chef now she has her own sous chef, Jocko. You're a foodie.
Yeah.
Hey, absolutely.
Love.
Listen, I forced my way upon this segment. I saw that, my man Aaron.
Pretty aggressive.
You know the only bad thing about it? We get to learn how to do it, but we have to wait to eat because everybody at the counter gets to eat. Yeah, so please bring on the incredible grilled cheese sandwich.
Oh, wow. Look
Chef Eric Greenspan has trained
Perfect.
In Paris.
Oh. Trained in Paris, absolutely. Went to the Cordon Bleu.
Yeah, oh, excuse me. Nice. Well, wow. That's
Ooh,
oh, my God. Okay, so he competed also on the Food Network's The Next Iron Chef. How hard was that?
I lost, so it eventually got real hard.
Yeah, I know.
We did okay. I won Iron Chef, though, later on, so we redeemed ourselves.
We are in the presence of an Iron Chef, you guys.
No, I beat an Iron Chef.
Oh, you beat an Iron Chef. Well, that's just...
Didn't become one myself,
still,
no need.
Still. Okay, he's run several acclaimed restaurants here, but it was not until his epic grilled cheese sandwich that propelled him, his whole career, into a whole new other stratosphere. So what is you do this whole cheese? You came up with a new concept for grilled cheese.
Well, the idea was, look, I opened up my first restaurant called The Foundry on Melrose.
Foundry.
We opened up on Melrose Avenue, and not like the boutique-y part of Melrose, like the T-shirt kind of part of Melrose. Mm-hmm. And so I wanted the restaurant to be accessible. It was fancy food, but kind of like fancy schmancy, like I like.
Okay, need to stop right now. Okay. Hang on 1 second.
Crazy.
Okay, Mark.
Moaning.
No, I could see your face. And then you have that look. That look. That's the look that he had.
I will tell you how good this is.
Yeah. What?
I actually feel like I should be nice to Kim Douglas right now.
Oh, that's how good it is.
That is how good this is.
That is amazing. Or as we would say back home, bloody amazing.
Bloody amazing.
We'll take it.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, it was an interpretation. We wanted to do a cheese plate, but we wanted to be like, oh, ha, ha, ha. So we figured we'd take everything from a cheese plate, and we turned to a grilled cheese sandwich, and people were like, oh, I don't like cheese plates. No, I'm not that fancy. Yeah. But a grilled cheese sandwich. We're like, oh, I love grilled cheese sandwiches. So we figured sneak attack them.
Okay. Well, would you like to learn how to make this?
Absolutely.
Okay. So let's go. You want to take your jacket off or keep it on? Let's go.
I'm gonna follow my man.
All right. It starts. I'll make one. You can make one. Okay.
So
starts with raisin walnut bread.
Yes.
You know, like that classic kind of nutty bread that you would see on a cheese plate. So you're worth me.
All right.
Then I always see dried fruit. They always have dried fruits or sort of like pickled vegetables and stuff like that on a cheese plate. So I made what is called an apricot caper puree, which is basically just dried apricots and capers, some olive oil, a little bit of mustard, and you just blend it all together. It makes like a chutney, but it's like kind of like
a chutney.
It's like fancy schmancy honey mustard, pretty much. It makes your mouth go nah, and then everything kind of tastes delicious.
Don't you have something called fancy schmancy?
I like to consider all of my cuisine fancy schmancy.
Okay.
We're just going to keep going to the word over and over and over.
All right. Let's talk about the cheese now. We're not talking about American cheese, American yellow cheese.
Not that there's anything wrong with American cheese.
There's nothing wrong with
it. I'm down with the classic grilled cheese, but for me, I like to use my favorite kind of cheese to use for grilled cheese sandwiches are cheese that it's doing the work for me. Hmm. It's those kind of soft, bloomy rind, like a brie, or in this case, a Taleggio.
I love brie.
Which is an Italian cheese, cow's milk, kind of stinky, a little strong, but it kind of holds up to all the different flavors. So it's, and what's good about it is that when it's here at room temp, right?
Thank you so much.
It's already kind of gooey.
Is that's it like good. Melty and gooey?
And so there's nothing worse than a grilled cheese sandwich.
Does the work for you, he said.
There's nothing worse than a grilled cheese that doesn't have melted cheese on it. That's you, your neck.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I get to do that?
All right, that's you.
Oh,
so you just spread the cheese on there.
All right.
And then after that, we started to get a little funky.
All right, look, I didn't win Iron Chef, so
that's cool, though.
I'm just gonna do it like this. And put a little bit more like that.
Or you just do this.
Oh. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
By the way, just there we go. Record, yeah. This way, Christina describes me as stinky and kind of strong.
Yeah. From Lombardi.
I didn't realize she was giving me
a
compliment.
You're basically Telegio.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Telegio. All right, now, can we talk a little bit, though? Okay, go ahead, and then I'm going to ask you the question.
Okay, what so these are some sun-dried tomatoes.
Oh, wow.
Good.
Great. Oh, you come up with this.
Okay.
And then a little arugula.
Arugula. And then you have some ribs over there?
Yeah, and then we got crazy, and we found some extra short ribs lying around the restaurant. We're like, oh, what the hell?
So you put them in.
Might as well put those in the sandwich. Boom. Now, I know a lot of people are like, oh, that's not really a grilled cheese sandwich. It's like a short rib sandwich.
No.
But there's rules, and the rules are, as far from the Grilled Cheese Invitational, which is a competition that I won, which is as long as it's 65% cheese, it's a grilled cheese sandwich.
Okay.
So we're going for it. Anybody who takes it too seriously to say it's not a grilled cheese sandwich takes themselves too seriously.
Can we talk a little bit about the butter and how you do this now? Because this is pretty hot.
Yeah.
This is really super hot.
The pan super ripping hot. I like cooking in a cast iron pan.
Okay.
Because it kind of keeps the heat, and I'll drop the butter right in
there. But it evenly displaces
the heat.
It evenly displaces it,
and it allows you to get a nice
coloration,
right?
It evenly displaces it.
I'll be talking later about vertical gardening.
Wow.
And I take it and I kind of move the butter around. And I like to get it nice and browned like that because that kind of gives it. Ooh. The color.
Now, what's the trick to cooking this now? Because I know there's a technique.
Couple tricks.
What?
Okay. Right. Trick number one is mediocre bread.
Okay.
And I know that sounds funny. Not bad bread, because that would be crazy.
Right.
But mediocre bread, because, these days in America, there's like this movement for like great artisanal bakeries and stuff like that. And they're awesome. And I believe in them. But they use such good starters and yeasty products so that they get bubbles everywhere. Mm. And so you have an uneven browned sandwich. So I say that's great stuff. Leave it for your cheese plate. But for me, I like mediocre bread.
And hey, listen, I'm from Texas, so I really approve of the ribs on the grill.
Nice, right?
Yeah, I love it.
All right, rule number two is use a lot of butter.
Okay, all right.
Or enough. I'm not going to say a lot.
Okay. And rule number three is
you want to keep moving the sandwich in the pan.
Why?
So that if the pan is uneven, make it brown a lot evener.
Okay, so while that's evening out, Jocko, you want to take this and bring it over there? We're going to reveal. Look at that. We're going to reveal the sandwich.
Let's take it over. I'll tell everybody Eric has a new show out. It's called Eric Greenspan is Hungry.
Yeah.
Okay, let's check it out.
Now that you're leaving this show, it airs on Nat Geo in November. Look at that.
Scoop that
out of the pan. Right. By the way, Eric's sandwiches, more information can be found at greenspansgrillcheese.com. Jocko, bite into that bad boy. It's so good. Recipe for the champ is waiting for you on our website, homeandfamilytv.com. Eric, I thank you.
I thank you.
You guys enjoyed? It was good?
Well done, Eric.
Amazing.
Kim Douglas, you are up.
Well, we go from Eric's grilled cheese to a baby pacifier with a grill. All kinds of fun stuff coming up. From grill to grill.
We have stepped outside, and we could stand here and spend the entire day talking about Jamie Durie's accomplishments. In addition to the many, many TV programs we talked about, he's also created a host of worldwide. He's also currently in production on a new gardening makeover show. He's running an international design firm, a magazine, designs a line of furniture. He serves, along with our good friend Olivia Newton-John, as the ambassador for Tree Day in Australia and has acted as the Dalai Lama's personal choice of environmental spokesperson on the campaign to save this wonderful planet that we live on. That is just the tiny short list of this very busy man.
And I am standing up. I know I'm rather short, but I am standing
You're
up.
You're standing on a long list of accomplishments, I'll tell you that.
You really are a man on a mission. So tell us about what it is that you're doing to connect the outside world and connecting us with nature.
Well, essentially, I'm a firm believer that gardens really do provide you with a sense of well-being, you know? So when you can reconnect people with plants in any form, it's a great thing. I mean, children study better, crimes have been reduced in places like China and even New York when gardens have been installed in urban areas. So I think, you know, it's a great thing for us to experience. It just gives us a bit of peace too, you know, in the backyard. So what I do is really just build outdoor environments where we can really start to live in our landscape rather than just look at it.
Yeah, which is actually something Will is doing. Like, he takes on these projects.
Yeah, I'm doing my yard right now, a lot of natives, and I just experienced that, what you were talking about. They said I could crash your segment because I want to do this at my house right now.
Oh,
they
yeah.
told us how to do that.
You'll love this because everyone has an ugly fence or an ugly wall. You know, like there's something like that in every landscape. And so what would you rather look at? Gorgeous plants with edibles or an ugly fence, you know?
Isn't that beautiful? It's so
did we roll in? I didn't have a chance to see. Did we roll in some of the examples of his work at all? Because I'm telling you, it's really remarkable when you see it. And then we're going to. Yeah.
There you go.
Here's some of the environments. The befores and afters.
That's actually my place here in California.
Oh.
And we got to do it on the show. It was so exciting. So I converted every single room into an outdoor space. And this was my show called The Outdoor Room on HGTV. And I'm now working on another network on a new show.
Wow.
Fantastic.
You're busy.
Can you talk about it? You say what the show is real quick?
Well, it's a makeover show with a twist.
Okay.
Where we make over not just the garden, but also the family.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh.
Okay, well, welcome to Home and Family. You can come here and do it for us. Or explain to us how this concept works.
Yeah, well, this is something I developed over a period
over
of
here?
5 years because I became very frustrated with the fact that there was a lot of vertical garden
There's a bee right there. Oh,
don't worry. There's a bee. I'm not allergic to bees.
Okay.
In fact, I encourage bees. That's what this whole things about. Bring bees back into this area because, you know, we're suffering a bit of a decline of the bee population.
Yes, we are.
Oh.
As you would know. So the more polystemonous plants or plants that produce flowers so we can increase the population of the bees is great. The other thing is what I've done is I've mixed in a series of edible plants and ornamentals. So like you've got a veggie patch here, sure, that's great. But what this is about is mixing your vegetable patch with your flowers and then taking it up onto a vertical plane to cover the fence.
Well, I know you do companion planting. Is that what you're talking about? What is companion planting?
Yeah, what is that?
Exactly. So companion planting is all about planting edible plants with species of plants that detract pests or insects from coming into that garden. So things like marigolds or geraniums are great, you know, pest deterrents, if you like. So
they'll go after the geraniums and the...
They don't like the taste of the geraniums.
They don't like the taste, so it keeps them away from...
It keeps them away, yeah. Right, and marigolds, exactly. the same thing. They don't like it, so it keeps it away. So you can see I've mixed a few things in there as well. But I've got New Guinean patients down the bottom. I've got some lettuce here. I've got some oregano over here. I've got some gorgeous. Now this is a native grass, by the way, which is really nice. It's Isolepis. So you can throw anything you like in here, and the idea is that you've got 22 pockets all the way across one big blanket with a waterproof membrane on the back. It's got irrigation lines running through it, so that you responsibly water the garden and it's getting reliable moisture.
Do that responsibly. What's your question?
I have a question. So how high can you go with something like this?
Well, mate, you can go as high as you like. You're in the entertainment business, aren't you?
But don't you do skyscrapers too? Are you working on one?
Yes. It's funny you say that because we're about to do a new project that's a 72-story high building, and we're doing this vertical garden the building. So it's amazing.
It's amazing.
So how this looks like it's complicated because you're talking about running water lines and stuff like that. And
no, it's
show
it's,
us.
It's how, pretty. Yeah, it's pretty simple. So essentially, I'll pull out a couple of these. So this is really easy. I'll pull the sage out. So there you go. And then I'll pull out. Whoop, I just broke one.
Sorry, we actually have the video of this kind of coming together as this wall was blank this morning. Let's take a look at it. Here is the wall, I guess, going up, right, Jamie? And then
wall going up. And you can see we just basically connect it to the fence. We just screw it straight into the fence because it's got a waterproof membrane on the back, so it doesn't allow any water transfer into the fence. And then the irrigation system keeps it, you know, with reliable moisture. So you only got to water it 3 times a week for 4 minutes in the morning, and you are good to go. And you can, you know, you can pick these up on my website, anywhere from $60 to $160, depending on what size.
Do you water from the top down, or you just water each row?
No, well, actually, the irrigation here runs on every row.
But
gravity works, and the water gets down to the bottom. And then as the top one dries out, capillary action pulls it back up. like dipping a beach towel into a bathtub. The water sort of runs through it.
Oh.
Yeah.
And that membrane, no problem putting it next to a house or something like that. It can be right on the wall of your house.
Exactly.
Oh, I love that idea.
So it's sort of vertical gardening for dummies, you know?
Yeah.
That is absolutely beautiful. I'd love to do our whole like that. It would be beautiful.
Yeah. Fantastic. I think we're going to have to do that. Put some plants in there and get some carrots growing.
I got some gorgeous flower here. You know, this one here is an angel face blue from my mates at Proven Winners. And I got to say, these guys really compliment. You can see I've gone with a cool color scheme here, so they really compliment it.
Perfect.
Thank you. Thank you.
So much more to discover about Jamie's projects, but he has a plane to catch. I know that, so he's heading out. Go to jamieduri.com. You can catch up with him, whatever plane he is on, whatever project he's got going. It'll be a good one to keep track of. Also, go to homeandfamilytv.com. All right, we're coming back. Jocko Sims went from the kitchen to the hot seat. We're going to chat with him, and he takes us behind the scenes at the making of the Dawn of the Planet of the Apes.
Beautiful color.
We're back. We're excited because we're doing this for the first time. It's a fun game. And it's a brand new game, as I said, called Movie Blast. Our family's divided into two. We'd like to say equal teams, but since
we're not, you got two amazing actors and you have us.
That's what I'm saying.
Come on.
We're taking them down.
Yeah. Oh, we are?
Yeah. So on my right, we have Christina and Kim, and they're led by Will Estes from Blue Blood.
Yay, Will.
On my left, we have Debbie and Tanya, and then Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, Sir Les Ship star. We have Jocko Sims here, and he is going to be leading the charge. The simple, fun game, you probably have done this a million times, because who hasn't read movie quotes or said movie lines to their friends in a moment where they want to underscore something that is appropriate? So each player will have a chance to read or deliver or act. We really like to see you act out a movie line. I will have those on here, and then it's up to your team to tell us what movie that is from. Here's the rule. You cannot give it your answer out until they're finished delivering the line. Got it?
Okay.
Got it? Okay, when you're done, you go to the end of the line, and then we'll move back up. If they don't get it correct, we're moving on. Brand new line, going over to the other team. The winner gets a million of something. Okay. All right, perfect. You guys ready?
Come on. Yeah.
We flipped a coin in the air. Christina's team won.
Oh!
And they deferred over to Jocko's team. So I don't know why that strategy was there. Okay, so Jocko, go ahead and stand up. I'm going to give you your first line. You can deliver this to your team.
All right, we're ready.
All right, there it is.
All right.
Mrs. Robinson, you're trying to seduce me, aren't you?
Oh, he's good.
The Graduate.
There we go. The Graduate. Boom. All right. You're at the end of the line. They got 1 point.
Right?
Will, come on. You can stand up here. Here you go. Here's your card.
You got one.
All right. Soak that one in a little bit.
This is. We're going to get this.
Okay.
All right. Life is like a box of chocolates.
You
didn't let me finish it. You didn't. Now you get nothing.
I know,
but these guys here, they're rule breakers. Well, you don't even know that. So you go to the end of the line, they can scoot down. Boy.
I'm not moving.
Maybe that's why you deferred. All right, Debbie is up. Here is your line. Wait, that's not it. Here's your line. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay, you guys. Here we go. Debbie, deliver this line. Here we go.
It's crazy.
Nobody puts baby in the corner.
Two men and a baby.
I know this. This is. I just heard it. How much time?
Nobody puts baby in the corner.
No. Okay.
I
can't get up here, Christina.
But that's the song that was playing.
You guys were so on it. Go to the other line. Move on down. Here we go. This is what's fun about it.
That's all right.
It's all good.
Okay, here we go.
Okay, ready?
Here we go. Hang on. Stand by. Rolling. Cameras are rolling. Quiet on set. Action.
You can't handle the truth.
Easy. One of my favorite movies, A Few Good Men.
There it is. We have a tie game. We have a tie game. Scoot on down. Kim, you're moving in this position. Tan, you stand up on your feet. Here we go.
All right. We got this.
Okay, we got it. All right.
Here we go.
Get your stinking paws off of me, you damn dirty ape.
Shall I?
Yes.
The original.
Dawn of the Planet of the Apes.
There we go. Yeah. There it is. Perfect.
There you go, baby.
Perfect.
I'm not,
all right.
I'm not.
Excuse me. Excuse me.
Yes.
What?
Wasn't it called Planet of the Apes?
Well, he got the original guess.
Okay.
He was
saying
the original.
Yes. Okay.
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 There it is.
Okay.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, what I consider one of the best actors of our time.
What?
Who will now put on a performance
right.
rarely seen at the shallow depths of what Kim Douglas can deliver. Please, take it away.
Okay. I'm getting in character, Mark.
Okay.
Okay. Love means never having to say you're sorry.
Love story.
Oh, wow. Okay.
It was before
all
your
right.
time.
Jackie,
I
come
know,
on
before
up.
Before your time.
We are tied at two apiece.
All right,
we
gotta
do this. Got this
okay.
one.
Actor, we gotta do this.
Ready?
All right.
We got it.
All right.
Okay.
Pull it together, Jocko.
We can do this.
I see dead people.
Oh, I'm Poltergeist.
No.
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 Oh.
Do you,
can she answer?
Debbie, do you know what it is?
I See Dead People was the M. Night Shyamalan thing.
Yeah.
The I See Dead People movie, the M. Night Shyamalan. M. Night Shyamalan is the director. He sees dead people.
We just need that
Bruce
title.
Willis is in it. No,
we
not
just
anymore.
Need that title.
Wow.
Guys, those
that one.
Stop jumping.
The baby. All right, all right.
It is. I'm sorry. The answer is
Sixth Sense.
Sorry.
I knew the director.
Okay. Here we go. This is a great, great movie line.
Poltergeist.
Okay. Right. This is for the win. For the win.
I gotta act this one.
Though. Okay. Just for the win.
All right. You ready?
Yes.
You had me at hello.
Oh, Jerry Maguire.
Oh, we have winners. Christina, Kim, Will are our winners. Here is your wonderful trophy. Oh, I almost dropped that. Thank you all for playing. What a fun time. It's a fun game to play, right?
Yeah.
Well, we're going to have more fun because, Tanya, you're up next. Oh.
Yes. You know, I might not be the greatest at movie trivia. Sorry.
Excuse me.
But what I'm really awesome at is making a crazy DIY for kids with tons of water, pool noodles, and PVC pipes coming up next.
Yeah. We're back. We gathered around. We got a little tips to share with you before we have our big makeover reveal, which is
yeah,
right
I can't wait
corner.
To see Julie.
Jocko's here. I'm as excited about seeing Planet as the last ship, by the way, which is a great idea. And you brought along a scene that
sure.
we want to share with people. Do we want? Does it need a little setup? Or?
Yeah. I play Lieutenant Burke, and this is a clip from the last ship. This is the second episode. That premieres this Sunday.
And this is Michael Bay directed this on TNT, and it's about a ship that's surviving with the, I guess, the
there's a virus that is plaguing the Earth, and there's billions of people who have died, and we have a doctor aboard that we need to protect to make sure she can create the vaccine.
All right, well, you're
Wait, they call you
us.
In for this. Boy, you're always saving the Earth. Good for you, Jocko. Good for you.
Tech Team 1, advance! Tech 2, let's go! Muzzle down!
Sorry, sir!
Sorry, it's not gonna do Nettles any good when you shoot his head off that Gitmo. Now, Tac 1, Tac 2, reset! Do it again!
It's gonna take time, sir.
Time is something we don't have. Every day we don't come home with a vaccine is a day another 500,000 people die.
I just wanna make sure they're ready.
You'll get them there.
Yes, sir.
Oh.
Thank you so much.
I see one day both you and Will, we'll be playing our movie burst or blast thing, and you'll both have a line that you've delivered in one of your movies.
Oh,
we'll be
awesome.
Quoting you guys.
Out to God's ears.
Right. Do you have a tip for us, Will?
Yeah, I got a tip. People always ask me about the solar panel system that I have on my roof, and they say, well, you know, what's the first step? And that's like insulating your doors and your windows and switching over to LEDs, because if you minimize your energy need, then you can build a smaller system. You save money coming and going.
That's, good point.
Let me hug that man. Yeah.
There you go, there it is.
I didn't realize you were an eco-warrior, too. That's right.
Eric, how can I make my grilled cheese better? What do you have for
us?
You know
what, how to make your grilled cheese better? Throw away your recipes and just cook. I think when you just get creative, the worst thing that can happen is you make a mistake, and some of the best dishes I've ever come up with come from mistakes. So throw away recipes and just goes then.
Yeah. Jamie, have you made mistakes?
All the time, all the time. Yes, but my one big tip, of course, would be you now know where to get the vertical garden blanket, because we did that little segment, which is great, and I want you all to cover up your fences. You grab this book, and I'll tell you exactly what to plant in it, edibles and ornamentals, so you can mix them together.
We didn't have time to get into that. I had a million questions about that, but now I've got a book I'm going to steal from you. Kimmy, I don't know what you're wearing now, but...
What do you mean? What do you mean? Well, do you mind if I stand up?
No, please.
I'm just going to stand up. Thank you, Debbie. Because if you don't want to hang your child on the back of the door, you could hang your... Oh, sorry, little Kim. And you could just wear her in your vest, Eric. Look, and you could just have your little, like, vest. And
like
there you
kangaroo.
Are.
Like
that I like.
She's like, it's cute. Like a Joey.
Yeah.
And then you just part of the world.
It is.
So I just have all these fun, new, innovative ways to bring that the baby. Could I have some grilled cheese? And can I have a makeover?
There you go.
All right. Debbie, do you have a...
I love you, Kim.
I know the makeover's still coming.
Oh, gosh, you guys, I can't wait for you to see this makeover. It is really amazing, and I have to tell you, it's taken a little longer today because I've never seen one person with so much hair in my life. Jolie has so much hair, and you won't believe what's been done with it. Here's my quick tip for pregnant girls. As you start to grow, it's good to get dresses like this because look at that. I can go up to 9 months.
Oh, look at that.
And I'll be okay. Oh, okay.
Nice. Ooh. Is it going to point out?
Six and a half?
Like,
nine. I'm going to have a pointy one. Yeah. It's going to be like a cone
right
head.
Right to your belly button starts to pop out.
I know. My sister already said. My sister said when the belly button pops out, it's like the timer on the turkey.
That's right. There you go.
Perfect. Tanya, do you have something for us?
Well, you know, if you topple over with a tricycle attached to you, you can't get it off. I don't know if you saw that. It was very, very thank you.
That was funny. That was adorable.
For the DIY car wash, think outside of the box and make it into an obstacle race. You can have a slip and slide, little bean bags, a little egg toss, and then whoever makes it through the car wash first wins the game.
Looking at the car wash. You know that's the song. It's in my head. You know, it's also in my head is The Last Ship, by the way. Sunday's 9 o'clock TNT. Jocko's going to be there barking out orders. You don't want him to come to you knocking on your door telling you to watch his show. All right, we're coming right back. Debbie.
We have our big reveal coming up.
Big hair.
It's a huge reveal.
All right.
It's a huge reveal.
Don't go away.